7 norske amerikanere I moderlandet for å få sin største drøm oppfylt. Et møte med sin norske slekt.
Knowing that I have family here, I really hope that I get the chance to meet them. It would be so meaningful.
I ulike konkurranser må de vise at de klarer å tilpasse seg den norske hverdagen. Men hver uke må den som gjør det dårligst reise hjem til Amerika med uforrettet sak.
Yeah! I'm here to win, and I'm here to meet my family, so I'm gonna work my butt off.
Til slutt står det igjen en vinner som dermed får møte sin norske familie.
Family means a lot to me. I am here to take this all the way. My Viking is ready to fight.
Tidligere har amerikanerne lært et og annet om det norske styresettet.
This is him. I think this is Jens.
Norsk historie.
Skål til Thor!
Og norsk kultur.
Get that painting and get the hell out of there.
Go, go, go!
Denne uka skal det handle om norsk barndom. Denne uka har vi valgt å la amerikanerne nyte glade sommerdager på Sørlandet, nærmere bestemt I Kristiansand. Og når sola skinner, dette et paradis for både store og små.
Det én ting vi nordmenn har til felles, så det at vi har vært norske barn. Vi har alle sammen kost oss med de lange norske sommerferiene. Vi har lekt ute på vinteren til vi blir blåfrosne. Vi har spist lørdagsgodt, vi har hørt på barnetimen for de minste, og vi har sett på barnetv. Ukas tema rett og slett norsk barndom.
Norske barn fødes inn I verden med et glimrende utgangspunkt. Og de nyter ofte godt av nettopp det. Selv om det å være barn I Norge var annerledes før enn det nå, det likevel mange barndomsminner vi deler på tvers av generasjonene. Vi har lekt mange av de samme lekene, hørt de samme sangene, Og dagens barn vokser opp med flere av de samme historiene som besteforeldrene ble fortalt da de var små. Noe alle norske barn har til felles naturopplevelser. Om vinteren blir vi dratt ut på ski allerede når vi en neve store. Når snøen smelter fortsatt gleden stor over endelig å kunne hoppe paradis. Og når sommeren kommer det selvfølgelig ut og fange krabber.
Hi! Look at this! So, what do you think of this week's theme?
Yeah!
The theme is Norwegian childhood. I've been celebrating that for 6 weeks already. I'm ready to go.
Liv, have you brought out your inner Norwegian child yet?
Oh, I'm so excited. I hope we get rewarded with ice cream and candy. Kids make me uncomfortable. But if it involves me being a kid, I think I'm a pro. I think I've had a lot of experience.
Soon you'll get to do an activity that all Norwegians do during their childhood. And one of their favorite activities is to go search for crabs.
Woo!
Okay. Okay. So what are you going to do? You're going to find one crab each that you have faith in. And these crabs will compete against each other in a crab race!
Oh, I was so pumped. It's like we get to go hunting for crabs on the shoreline here in beautiful southern Norway. Yes, sign me up. I'm down. I was really excited.
Ukas første lagkonkurranse altså et krabbeløp. Men for å arrangere et slikt løp, mangler amerikanerne fortsatt det viktigste, nemlig krabbene. Lagvis skal rødt og blått lag forsøke å fange de raskeste krabbene. Siden Colby vant immunitet forrige uke, slipper han å konkurrere I dag. Og når lagene skal fange krabber, kan det være lurt å hente inn litt lokal ekspertise.
Do you know how to find crabs in the water?
Yes.
Okay, can you show us?
She's an expert. Look at
that.
I'm so excited. Okay. These girls were fearless. They're like, yeah, come follow us. And we're all of a sudden hiking on the side of this rock wall, perilously looking at our death, the water, and the side of the wall. I mean, if all Norwegian children are like this, wow, very impressive.
Yeah. I think I could catch you with this, Eric, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, I'm a pretty big fan of mussels, that's true.
We're out catching crabs. I do that just for shits and giggles anyway. And I know it's not easy. There's a lot of waiting.
I'm not seeing any crabs.
I don't either.
I saw one over there, but he ran away. Really,
I think they call them krabba. Is that...
Apparently, Norwegian crabs are tougher to satisfy or tougher to please than American crabs. In America, we throw a hot dog out and there's like three crayfish on it like that. But here, the crabs can be more selective, much like many other Norwegians, I think.
Det viser seg at amerikanerne har litt problemer med krabbefiske.
Hvor de?
Faktisk så store problemer at hele krabbeløpet står I fare.
You're obviously not as talented as Norwegian kids when it comes to searching for crabs.
That's a pretty high bar.
Så nå har vi juksa litt grann. This is some extra crabs.
All right. Yes.
Reglene I krabbeløpet enkle. Hvert lag har tre krabber på startstreken. Og dermed tre sjanser til å vinne.
This one's got his mouth open. He's like, ah, bring it on.
My crab is a pretty feisty one. This was the first one picked out. So when we picked him out, he had that that look in his eyes.
He looks mean.
He looks ready. I like
that. Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it.
Den første krabben I mål, eller eventuelt den krabben som har kommet lengst I løpet av 10 minutter, vinner hele lagkonkurransen for sitt lag.
If you don't make it across that finish line, I'm going to ship you to the North Pole. Seriously. Come on. Get it together.
Okay, are you ready?
Ready.
Yeah. Ready? Set. Go.
We do not take.
Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go. Go, go, go. Go, go, go. Go, go, go. Go, go,
go.
Go, get it. Go. Get out of here. And go.
Go.
Henrietta said, go, and the crabs did not go. They did the opposite of going, which is that they just died.
Come on, come on.
You're embarrassing yourself. No ice cream for you tonight. That was worked for me.
Oh.
She's moving.
She's moving, and she wants to move. Okay,
yeah,
keep it going.
Come on.
All of a sudden, there's little life, you know, and she started bringing up her claws and digging a little bit. I'm like, stop digging. You gotta go.
Come on. You got it.
Travis just kept yelling and yelling. I think if he thought, if he shook his fist near enough to the crab, that it would run.
Keep it going. Go faster. Go faster. Go, go faster. Go faster.
No. Walk. No.
Walk.
That
walk.
That way.
Hell out of
that
here.
Way.
Go faster. Go.
Travis sin intense heiing ser ut til å hjelpe. Og krabben hans sørger for at blått lag tar en liten ledelse. Men etter den intense anstrengelsen av å ha gått ca. 10 cm, ser det ut til at krabben trenger å ta en liten pust I bakken. Og uheldigvis for blått lag har en av rødt lags krabber nå skjønt at ikke skal mye til for å vinne denne konkurransen.
Oh, she's coming in hot.
Travis's crab took off, and I think my crab sensed that, and I put the fire under his belly to go.
Go!
Go!
Keep moving!
Det ekstremt bedagelige tempoet til krabbene gjør det åpenbart at ingen av dem vil klare å krysse mållinjen før tidsfristen på 10 minutter omme. Foreløpig det blått lag med Travis sin krabbe som leder, siden den kommet lengst. Og tiden begynner å renne ut, så om Livs krabbe skal klare å snyte blått lag for seieren, den nødt til å få opp dampen.
Let's go! Keep moving! You're so close! You're so close! That way! That way! I don't think he was a distance crab, because all of a sudden he decided to stop. Maybe take a break, rehydrate, muster himself for the rest. But he didn't start again.
What happened? Rachel. We had such a good thing going.
Oh, we had a great start, but a horrible finish. Wow.
I knew at that point that our team had the most ambitious crab of the very lazy crabs. and that it was going to secure us the advantage in the next team competition.
And time's up.
Go.
The winners are Team Blue.
All right. All right.
And Blue Team, you earned yourself an advantage in the next team competition. And the advantage is Colby.
We'll see how much advantage that is.
I'm really excited to have the advantage. I definitely want another week with no individual challenges.
I'm not going to tell you what the next team competition is until tomorrow. But what I am going to tell you is where you're going to spend the night. It's right here.
All right.
I'm excited to camp. I grew up camping, and we're camping in such a beautiful place and the beach, so I'm really excited. I think we might have a sing-along.
And you're probably hungry?
Yeah. Yes.
So your dinner is these.
Oh. I think once we stopped crawling, his new name became Lunch, and I think he very much deserves his fate.
Okay, children, go have fun camping.
Yeah. Thank you.
Adebra.
When I saw the tent camp, I felt like, oh, great, I'm going home. I love camping. Eric, you ready to cook some crab?
Yeah, let's give those crabs a proper journey to Valhalla and via my stomachala.
Show the way, Eric. Teach us.
We got to have delicious crabs, which is something that I really... Some of my best memories are of my dad and me, and we were crabbing at the beach and learning that craft and then cooking the crabs up afterwards. It's been years since I cooked up crabs with dad, but it all came rushing back to me.
Mens Liv, Colby, Travis og Eric gjør middagen helt klar, de andre I full gang med å sjekke ut fasilitetene.
What is that?
Ooh, look at
books. Stories.
Stories, yeah.
Children's stories.
Which kind?
And then
a bag. Dume mom.
Bags? Wow, candy bags, I think. Feels like sand.
Let's go take a look at these books, guys.
Yeah, let's do that, yeah.
All right, let's see what we got here.
Let's see what we got.
I'm interested in this one. Den dumme mannen. Is this the dumb man?
Oh.
Everyone check.
Thank you.
Sure. Den lille muldvarpen. He's got like a little...
Does he have poop on his
That's
head?
What it kind of looks like, yeah. Som vil vit hem som hada viasjet på hot hans.
That's a really long title.
Honestly, I've been trying to figure out what I should bring home to my nieces and nephews, and I think I just found the perfect souvenir. Books about people pooing and peeing. They are absolutely going to love it.
He does not look happy either.
What have you got over here?
I have Carius and Bactus. And when the robbers came to Cardamon Town. Once upon a time, there was a boy, and his name was Jens. He had teeth in his mouth like everyone else, but in one of his teeth, Jens had a cavity. And in this cavity lived two tiny fellows named Carius and Bactus.
If the books we read were any indication of what children's literature is as a whole in Norway, I think it's cool that it kind of presents a little bit of a darker, more realistic, gritty vibe versus like sort of the like happy-go-lucky princesses get rescued by princes and whisked off to castles that we typically try to jam into our children in the U.S.
Yoo-hoo!
Dinner's ready.
All right.
Nice.
We have some treats for you.
Yay.
We love treats. Might not recognize them from earlier. Ta-da.
Oh.
Yes. I think you like them better now that they're dead.
Yeah.
Surprisingly, not much slower.
Oh, wait. All right. Come. Should we school? Okay. To our inner Norwegian child.
All crab warriors.
Oh.
And the kids and all of us.
Norsk-amerikanerne koser seg med et deilig krabbemåltid I sommervarmen. Men for en av dem har fortsatt dagen mer å by på enn piknik og teltliv. Det nemlig Eriks tur til å lære mer om sine norske forfedre.
Birds.
Oh man, there's a bunch of stuff. Dear Eric. Your great-great-grandfather, Hans Danielsen Hovland,
was a teacher and a small holder. A unique letter, nearly lost to the flames of a burning house and written by Hans D. to his son and your great-grandfather Hans Hansen Hovland in 1882, shows the close bond the family had to one another and how much they loved and cared for each other.
Dette brevet beskriver en del av familiehistorien som Eric ikke tidligere har vært klar over.
The old family myth that Hans H. was a bachelor when he emigrated is not quite correct. Oh, no kidding. In fact, he had a girlfriend and a newborn son who he left behind in Bergen to seek his fortune in America in 1887. Holy smoke. That is totally different than I knew. The child was born out of wedlock, which was a serious sin in the 19th century. But Hans H. Hovland was not brought up to leave others to suffer from, oh man, from his actions. But instead, to respect, love, and care for friends and family. Of course, that shouldn't even surprise me. So he crossed the Atlantic, married Elisa in Bergen, and emigrated back to America in 1893, this time together with his wife and son. Wow, that's super cool. This letter tells me a whole lot about my family I just didn't know. He could have gone a country away and just stayed and started a whole new life, but it's not the Hovland way. He went back and he took care of his family, and I'm really proud of that. Or I wouldn't be here.
Det tidlig morgen I Kristiansand, og amerikanerne våkner, glade og fornøyde over de rike mulighetene teltliv ved stranda har å by på.
I think we're gonna go get geared up for a morning swim, perhaps.
Yeah!
Whoa.
Keep an eye. No. What? Whoa. He slept in his...
I'm ready to go swimming.
Best way, we decided to wake up in Norway was go for a swim.
Baywatch it?
I have been accused of.
I don't know if your hair is ready for
I have been accused of looking like David Hasselhoff more than a few times.
Don't hassle
like
the
David Hasselhoff. Hasselhoff, yeah.
Get my hassle hair up.
Yeah. It's very cool.
Arctic,
is it last week? Real warm?
That is so much. All right.
Hugh gets wet first, gets to torment everybody else by kick splashing everybody, and I didn't waste any time at all splashing the nearest team members.
I did the worst approach ever, which is to go a little bit in, and fortunately my teammates were not about to let me get away with that.
If I could choose a way to wake up, it should always involve throwing somebody in icy cold water. So Barrett got what was coming to her.
Om noen sier, ikke gjør som mora di sier, Jens, eller snakker om å spise sjøbanan til frokost, da vil nok de fleste nordmenn ikke gjenkjenne. For alle som har vokst opp I Norge har jo sine kjære favorittfigurer, enten det fra barnetv eller fra barnebøker. Vi har gamle kjente karakterer som Karis og Baktus, vi har Knerten eller Titten Tei, eller så har vi nye favoritter som Fatorangen, Kurt eller Blånissene. Og I dag så skal norskamerikanerne lære om nettopp norske barnefigurer.
Før ukas andre lagkonkurranse får deltakerne utlevert bilder av noen av de aller første figurene norske barn lærer å kjenne. Men som tydeligvis ikke har vært en del av den norsk-amerikanske barndommen.
Ok, is he a moose?
Or that's Jerry.
He's a cow. He's gotta be a cow,
this
right?
That's like Barney. I really don't know what's going on in this picture, but this guy needs to watch his hands.
Where again? Who that is.
It's you.
It's another
theme.
Must-
it's a portrait. Oh my God. I know.
Some of the characters and I have something very significant in common. I saw some rockin' mustaches in there.
Whoa.
Oh. A pirate?
Scary pirate.
A drag pirate. He's a gay pirate. He's got lipstick on. He's a drag queen. Let's be real.
De to lagene har nå en time hver seg for å lære seg så mye som mulig om noen av de viktigste fiktive karakterene I norske barns liv, før de skal få kunnskapen testet I en quiz som vil avgjøre hvem som får nok en uke I Norge, og hvem som må kjempe mot hverandre for å unngå den fryktede returbilletten til USA.
Winning today means that I'll get to stay in Norway another week, and so far it keeps getting better and better. And that's my motivation. I want to stay in Norway, and I want to make it to the end and meet my family.
Hi, hi. Snakker du engelsk? Ja. Do you know who this is?
Yes, it's Captain Sabeltan, as we call it in Norway.
Captain Sabeltan?
Yeah, Sabeltooth.
Sabeltooth, oh.
Sabeltooth, oh. Yeah.
Pirate-looking guy was the first one we saw. Holy cow. That Jack Sparrow's got nothing on this guy. It's kind of like pirate mime. I'm not sure what's going on there, but he definitely has a presence.
Thank you.
Is this... It looks like him, right?
Yeah.
Kan du snakke engelsk?
Ja.
Twiggy. Is this guy's name Twiggy?
Knack.
Knack. Knack.
Do you know who this is?
This is Fantorangen from 6 to 6:30.
It's like between commercials.
Yeah. Oh, there's no commercial.
Oh, no commercial.
No commercial. On NRK, no.
Oh, okay.
He just looks crazy. Because his eyes are dilated, he might be on meth. I'm just letting you know.
Titten Tei, André van Rey. Det mitt navn for det heter jeg. Titten Tei, André van Rey. Var det ikke det? André van Rey. I don't remember more.
Titten Tei, Titten Tei. Titten Tei, Frey for Drey. Drey for Drey. Titten Tei, Drey for Drey.
Do you know her?
Ja,
Tante Sofie.
Mens amerikanerne fordyper seg I gamle barne-TV-helter, tar vi en aldri så liten pause. Men når vi tilbake, får amerikanerne oppleve enda flere sider av norske barns fantastiske fantasiverden.
We live in the town, you guys! Like, we have a place in the town!
Men der jo barbermester Sørensen.
I don't have anything that needs to be shaved.
Norske amerikanere I moderlandet for første gang og konkurrerer for å få sin største drøm oppfylt, et møte med sin norske slekt.
I'm looking forward to meeting my family and just having a taste of what it's like to get to know more about them.
The winners are Team Blue! Yay!
Før pausen vant blått lag den første lagkonkurransen, og de fikk dermed fordelen av å få med Colby på laget når de skulle tilegne seg kunnskap om kjente og kjære norske barnefigurer.
Is this guy's name Twiggy?
Knack.
Nå har alvorets time kommet. Kunnskapen de to lagene har tilegnet seg skal settes på prøve I den siste lagkonkurransen. En quiz som vil sikre vinnerne en uke til I Norge, mens taperne må møte hverandre I en ny konkurranse som vil sende en av dem sporenstreks ut av landet.
Dere klare?
Yeah.
Question number one. What does Tante Sofia say when she's angry? Is it A? Oh, hyffa meg, jeg så sint, Sofie. Or is it B? Oh, hyfsa tufs, jeg vil ut og fly. Or is it C? Oh, hytte meg tu, og tidlig bom. Team Red, what is your answer?
Red team chose A. Ohu fameg, Jaeger sa sin som fi.
And what about you?
Team Blue chose A. Ohu famai, Jaeger so sin som fi.
And the correct answer is A. Ohu famai, jeg så sin som fi.
What does Sola Gunnarsen from Flåklypa Grand Prix often say?
Does he say A? Dra meg forlengs inn I statskassa. B. Dra meg sideveis inn I katteburet. Or C. Dra meg baklengs inn I fuglekassa.
It was a pretty hard quiz because there was so many things in Norwegian, but we just went with what seemed right.
Team Blue?
Team Blue chose B. Dra meg sideveis inn I katteburet.
Eric and Team Red, what's yours?
We chose A, Traumek Fallings in Strasskaska. Casa.
Well, the correct answer is C, drama baklängs in I fuglekassa. Which of these names are not cursed child? A, Lillekurt, B, Bud, or C, Mellomkurt?
I think we gotta go ahead because Lilla makes sense. Yeah. Okay.
Team Blue, what is your answer?
Team Blue said C, Mellomkurt.
What about you, Team Red?
Team Red said A, Lillekurt.
The correct answer is...
Immediately we're thinking, okay, they have the wrong one. They have the wrong one. And I was just sending negative vibes over to the blue team.
C, Mellomkurt. Oh. The main character in Blåfjell is called Turta. But what is her brother's name? Is it A, Tulling, B, Tvilling, or C, Trilling? Tiden ute. Team Red.
Team Red chose B, Tvilling.
Yeah, and Team Blue.
Oh, Blue. Blue chose C, Trilling.
The correct answer is... B, Tvilling.
Awesome.
Very good.
Yeah.
I was getting nervous. I'm like, the tide might be turning. We might be going in the wrong direction. I sure hope we've got an edge on these other questions.
This character's name is Titten Tai. But what is the rest of his name? Is it A, André von Drei? B, André Ergrei? Or C, André Postei?
I knew that answer because the ladies down at the stand in the water had told us the song and told us the answer.
Eric, what did Team Red answer?
Team Red chose A, André von Drei.
And what about you?
Team Blue chose A, André von Drei.
And the correct answer is A, André von Drei. It's time for the last question. What Norwegian TV channel is broadcasting Fantorangen? Is it A, Norsk Rikskringkasting, B, Norsk Ruskastrering, or C, Norsk Restskatteinnkreving?
When we had nothing to discuss and we were guessing on that question, we looked at the blue team and they seemed to be talking things out like, what are they even talking about? We have nothing on this one.
Time is up. Colby and Team Blue?
Team Blue said A, Norsk Riks Ringkasting.
Yeah, and Team Red?
Team Red said C, Norsk Reskratinskreven.
Norsk Reskratinskreven. The correct answer is... A, Norsk Rikskringkasting. So, congratulations, blue team!
Oh, goodness, thank you, Cole, for helping us out, bud.
So excited to have one more week in Norway. I feel like we're really getting closer and closer now to the end and meeting my family, my relatives, my awesome relatives.
Team Red, I'm really impressed by how much you learned so quick, but unfortunately you have to face each other in the individual competition tomorrow.
Great. Good job, guys.
Yep.
Good shot. I am not ready to go home. You know, we're all friends, but when we're in the competitions, we understand that it's a game that has to be won, and I want to be that winner.
I have a surprise for you. Because you all know Torbjørn Egner now, right? Mm-hmm. He is one of Norway's most famous writers when it comes to children's literature. And his universe is very special. And tonight, you are going to sleep in a cozy little town that every Norwegian knows all about, and it's called Kardemommeby.
Kardemommeby, wow.
You're going to have a great time.
Awesome.
Enjoy.
I'm excited to move into a fairy tale world. I mean, fairies everywhere, possibly. You know, princesses. Who wouldn't like that?
Nå kanskje ikke prinsesse og fetettheten aller størst i denne byen. Men at amerikanerne kommer til å få seg en eventyrlig opplevelse, det ingen tvil om.
Her i Kardemommeby, vi har det veldig godt. Her ingen bil, den riktige har vi fått. Trafikken heter linje 1 og går fra nord til sør. Og jeg trikkens riktige kommentør.
This whole city looks like it was lifted right from the pages of the book. And then I'm not sure where the author lifted it from, because it does not look like Norway.
Og i Kardemommeby tar man selvfølgelig imot sine gjester på høvelig vis.
Oh, you guys, wait.
Velkommen, 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 kjære venner. Jeg politimester Bastian og en vennlig mann. For det syns jeg man skal være hvis man kan. Og jeg går omkring og passer på at alle har det bra. For det synes jeg at alle skulle ha.
Inspector Bastian was very jolly. He definitely surprised us when he came out. He's speaking Norwegian and we have no idea what he's saying.
Dette en veldig viktig lov i Kardemommeby. Så alle får en utdelt. Og hvis dere skal bo her, så må alle kunne den. Man skal ikke plage andre.
Man skal ikke plage andre.
Man skal være grei og snill.
Man skal være grei og snill.
Og for øvrig kan man gjøre hva man vil.
Og for øvrig kan man gjøre hva man vil.
Du skal ikke plage andre. Something, something vil, no.
Fantastisk flott. Velkommen til Kardemommeby. Følg med meg. Følg med meg.
What did we just sign up for? We don't know what any of this means, but we're gonna go along with it, I guess.
Amerikanerne skal bo lagvis i Kardemommeby. Og Bastian har funnet et passende hus til det blå laget. Litt lenger ned i samme gate som tante Sofie.
Da skal blått lag bo her. Vær så god.
Takk.
Oh, it's got a little kitchen!
Oh.
I love it. We're living the town, you guys! Like, we have a place in the town! This is so cool!
Og på vei gjennom byen for å vise rødt lag deres hus, møter politimesteren på en gammel venn.
Men der jo barbermester Sørensen. Det noe de må se. Kom hit, min venn.
Kom hit.
Jeg visste de ville vite.
Ja, den var meget pen.
I was steered into the barber shop. My first thoughts were, I don't have anything that needs to be shaved. But they had other plans for me.
Oh my gosh, look at all.
Jeg klipper og barberer og friserer dagen lang. Men aller mest jeg liker best musikk og vise sang.
Eric's mustache is pretty precious to him, so he was like, you know, what's going on here?
Og når Tobias kommer med det lange skjegget sitt, da blander jeg litt såpevann og vasker skjegget litt.
And out comes the straight razor. And I thought, this is not what I signed up for. I really enjoyed it. It was probably the best shave I've ever had, and definitely the best shaving soundtrack.
Be careful, ladies of Kardemommeby.
Men som alle vet, ikke alt bare fryd og gammen i Kardemommeby.
I love
the fact that you get this.
I love our little house. Oh, yeah. How are you? Hey.
I walked down the stairs and I see three guys staring at me and I was like, whoa, I stepped back a little bit. What is going on?
I've read the story, so I'm like, these are the robbers. This is really happening. Like, we are accomplices to this robbery right now.
Shh. What did you know?
We're in Carnival Town for 5 minutes and already we're involved in a crime.
He's got a key. It's fine. He's got a key.
He's got a key.
Yeah. We're accessories.
Oh, yeah.
and they started handing us lots of baked goods. And I am no one to say no to a chocolate muffin.
Oh, you are a good man.
Jeg trodde jeg hadde lært dere alle sammen denne regelen. Og her står dere og har røvet fra bakeren allerede etter 2 minutter.
The rest of my team put their baskets down, and I had a big glass cake thing, so I couldn't put it down. So I got caught red-handed with all of the items.
Men jeg skal straks om en gang skrive det opp I boken min.
A ticket?
Og så skal jeg tenke nøye over saken mens jeg går bort til politimestersalongen.
Men våre norsk-amerikanske venner finner raskt ut at straffenivået I Kardemommeby ikke ligner noe særlig på det de vant med hjemmefra.
Da får dere beholde kakene. Og så får dere heller ha en veldig hyggelig kveld her I Kardemommeby.
Tusen takk.
To keep them. Oh my gosh.
I think we can go down this alley.
We'll make it back.
I can't believe we just stole a bunch of buns from the bakery.
I gave them the benefit of the doubt. I thought since they had the keys to the bakery, they had to be legit. But okay, fine. I knew it was under shady business. But how can you argue with these things? They're so good.
Go, go, go.
Blått lag avslutter dagen med stjålne godsaker fra bakeren. Og gjetordene om kvaliteten på søtsakene gjør at de tre på rødt lag neste morgen velger å starte det som meget vel kan bli deres siste dag I Norge med lovlig innkjøpt bakverk fra samme sted.
So how are you guys feeling about today?
Games are on. It's Might have a cardamom bee theme, I'm expecting.
At this point, I've gotten to know a little bit more about my relatives, and that is still the fuel in my fire. I'm looking forward to meeting my family, and just having a taste of what it's like to get to know more about them makes me that much more passionate, and I'm here to meet them.
Bottom line is, one of us will not be here after today.
It is so very important for me to stay in Norway. Ultimately, I want to meet the Hovlands, but I'm growing every day. I honestly feel like a better man, and I have just this great love for the country. I don't want to miss out on any of that.
How about we raise a cup and skål each other?
Let's do it.
Lykke til.
There's just nothing else I want more than to win and continue on this journey. I'm going to do my best, and I'm not going to be thinking about Liv or Eric. I'm just going to be thinking about my living Norwegian family and this opportunity to have this reunion with them.
There's no question in my mind that I'm going to come out on top in this competition because there's just no other option for me.
Huffa meg, huffa meg, jeg så sint, så fy, for alt bare tøys og tull I kar... Men I alle dager, hvem det som her så tidlig på morgen? Befar meg vel, dette må jeg undersøke!
Tante Sofia was shaking out a garment on the porch, spied us, and then started in with a cavalcade of what did not sound like encouraging words.
What color did it?
They're low carb, I swear.
Dette her ikke frokostmat. Unnskyld meg. Unnskyld meg.
Okay, yes.
Excuse you.
Kan dere høre hva jeg sier? Hva?
I think she was saying something along the lines of there's way too much sugar. You know, you guys are fatties, and this is not a low-carb option for breakfast.
Hallo! Hører du ikke hva jeg sier? Har de ikke vasket ørene I dag, kanskje?
I need to wash them well today.
Oh my gosh, yes.
I feel my... Oh,
I think she wants to reform us.
We didn't get the gist of what she was telling us, but she pointed out a lot about ears and possibly washing behind our ears.
Kunne de ta de ørene litt nøyere I kveld når de legger dem? Kan de love meg det? Har vi en avtale på det? Takk for det.
Takk.
Og så var det de, unge mann.
The trick to pleasing Tante Sofia was to just really agree with what she was saying, letting her know that we are listening, and I think you're right, and I'm going to be better going forward.
Ja, men da har vi en avtale på det da. Hva?
Hva?
Unge dame.
I grew up in a matriarch, so I know what it's like to have a woman in charge in the house, and this woman seems to be in charge of the entire village. I think Tante Sofia really runs the town, and the police master just takes a back seat and kind of watches things. So she wears the pants in Cardamoma Bee.
Unnskyld meg. God dag. Ja, mitt navn altså frøken Tante Sofie. Og de heter?
Andy.
Ja, reis deg opp.
Okay.
Og hilse pent. Ja, har de ikke lært å neie ordentlig da? Neie? Sånn, ja. Det her var det ordentlig rotete. Bevar meg. Røverne her? Det her de har gjemt seg? Hva? Ja, men så svar.
I guess I sort of felt like Aunt Sophia was saying, like, clean up your mess, you American slobs. What's wrong with you? Let me check behind your ears. You're dirty. Ugh. Go take a bath. Go to bed. Read, I don't know, something else.
Og her, og der det også en sak. Nei, du store all verden. Kanskje røverne her?
She told me I didn't clean my ears.
Og se her, ja. Nei, men dette jo ikke røverne, dette. Opp og stå! Klokken langt ut på dagen. Opp og stå! Hører du ikke hva jeg sier? Hva? La meg se på øret ditt. Få se. Nei, jeg skal bare se på øret.
This morning, Travis and I were woken up by a very angry woman that looked a little bit like Mary Poppins, but a lot meaner.
I don't know what's going on. I don't know what's going on.
Okay, you're Austin.
Oh, andre siden. Ja, så dere har ingen grunn til å ikke høre hva jeg sier. Hva dette her for slags? Opp og rydde.
She pointed out the mess on the floor, all of Travis's clothes and shoes. It was all Travis. It wasn't me. He's messy.
Kan vi få en avtale på det?
Hello?
Kan vi få en avtale på det? Avtale.
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 I think we agreed to cleaning our room. I think that's what it was.
I was like nervous.
She slapped my face. She goes, ugh. And I was like, oh, damn. I'm getting beat. I need to file a police report.
Oh, shoot.
Get your underwear. Clean up this
mess.
Right now.
Stop me. It's all Travis.
It's my shit.
Did you guys get a lovely awakening this morning from Aunt Sophia?
What was going on?
Maybe if you guys are cleaners, wouldn't have happened.
What just happened?
I know.
If we're not out of bed in like a couple of seconds, I don't think Sophia is going to react very well. We probably
let's get this cleaned up.
Og nå får du sjansen til å rydde et par minutter du også. Men ikke ta storrengjøringa, for straks avgjøres det hvem som blir den neste som må forlate alt for Norgeskuta.
Bring me treasure! If you cannot dazzle them with details, baffle them with bullshit, and I brought bucket loads. Go faster.
Før pausen tappte rødt lag ukas lagkonkurranser.
Blue team!
Og det derfor de som nå må ut i den individuelle konkurransen, som tar for seg en mye skumlere del av norsk barnekultur.
Oh, wow! The whole village! We are in the land of Captain Sabretooth. This is Pirate Villa extraordinaire.
Grimason, where's the poop to come about to lose?
I had no idea that pirates were so big in Norwegian culture, but hey, I'm on board. Yarr!
Welcome to Abrahavn!
Yay!
A real pirate village and the home of a pirate that all Norwegian children are absolutely crazy about. Kaptein Sabeltann! It's time to reveal what your task in the individual competition is. You are going to perform Kaptein Sabeltann's most famous song in front of an audience here in Abrahavn.
Av nyere norske barnefigurer den sortkledd pirat som den desidert største helten. Mens våre nordiske nabobarn oppflasket med søte troll og charmerende småbarn som gjør ufarlige rampestreker, norske barns favoritt en mørk, skummel pirat som ser ut som et bortkommet medlem av bandet Kiss. Kaptein Sabeltann ble kjent for nordmenn første gang i 1989. Piraten fikk raskt en hærskare av små piratfans, Til glede og iblant forargelse for norske piratforeldre. Grunnen til at norske småtroll er så gale etter den slemme piraten, finnes det ikke noe fasitsvar på. Men kanskje er det vikingblodet i norske barns årer som gjør at de liker tokt og røveri. Uansett, kongen på havet selv kan le sin sjørøverlatter hele veien til banken og videre etter det.
To help you guys, I have invited the original Captain Sabeltan, the creator of the character. Please welcome Captain Sabeltan himself, Terje Farmo!
Hi.
Terje is the creator of Captain Sabeltan, and he also played Captain Sabeltan himself for 11 years.
Oh, that's so cool.
I'm looking forward to hear you sing his most famous song. It goes like this. Hiv ohoi, snart skatten vår, så kan vi ta det rolig de neste 100 år. And you ready?
Yeah!
I've been looking forward to this my whole life. I've always wanted to be a professional pirate, so maybe they'll hire me after my performance.
De tre amerikanerne får nå bruke et par timer til å lære seg sangen om Kaptein Sabeltan.
Jumping about and stuff. And being a pirate and things.
Hello, how are you?
I am great.
Selvfølgelig under kyndig veiledning av kapteinen selv.
You're ready to become a pirate?
I was born ready to become a pirate.
I can see that.
Captain Sabeltan, her en farig mann.
Nå kan jeg lukte
gud for å vinne
inn mot land.
Nå kan jeg lukte
gud
for å vinne inn mot land.
Terje is the master of pirates. He just gave me his energy, that pirate expertise. Boy, you combine that with this mustache and we've got a winning combination.
Captain Sabeltan, er en farlig mann.
Nå kan jeg lukte gud.
Some of that pronunciation with all those R's in there, there's a lot of
Nan kan jeg lukte gul.
Derfor ror vi inn mot land.
Derfor.
There's
a lot of
Det ble jo litt mange R'er på et punkt her, så det er klart det baller seg litt grann da, men du verden så morsomt det er da.
Yeah! I absolutely have a strategy. It's called 20 years of gymnastics. I'm hoping to pull out some moves and stunts that might surprise the audience.
Vi seilte fra Karibien.
Når ankret opp i natt.
I don't have much experience singing, but it doesn't matter because I don't know the meaning of the words, so I think it'll be easier. I can just put my pirate into it. Yarr! Can you do the eyes for me?
Etter noen timers øving og moro, har tiden kommet for forestilling.
Hold on tight. This is gonna be cool. I can't wait.
Vi har invitert en rekke barn til det som kan komme til å bli en uforglemmelig Kaptein Sabeltan-forestilling. Velkommen til Alt for Norge, og velkommen til Abraham! Og det er denne gjengen som vil avgjøre hvem av de tre som har opplevd sin siste soloppgang i Norge for denne gang.
Right now, I'm not that nervous. I've been in a lot of performances in my life that involve gymnastics, where you're getting judged like out of a perfect 10. And I think kids are a little bit more forgiving.
Ta vel imot første deltaker. Her er Liv!
Vi satt i Karibien og engret opp i natt. Jeg har nok opp en gammel rekke inn for fastig skatt. Kapten Sabeltan er en farlig mann. Den lagde lukte kul, derfor ror vi hjem av land. Liv og hår, snart sakken vår. Så kan vi lukke gul, men det neste håndter av. Så kommer vi lov.
I really didn't notice the kids' reactions that much. I was hoping for a good reaction, but I honestly couldn't tell you if they were laughing or not.
Etter en heseblesende opptreden kan Liv gå av scenen uten at hun helt sikker på hvordan hun egentlig har gjort det.
Wait, what just happened? I really don't know what I did out there. But I feel like it went okay. I had a lot of fun, whatever it was.
Den neste som skal innta den sorte dame med sang og skuespill Greg.
I have a few butterflies, a little bit nervous, but I'm going to channel those into a dynamic, awesome performance.
Is that the Brocket Radian? Oh, great, up did not. Jeg har hørt det gammel etter om fantastisk snart. Captain Sabaton, Alec Fronlichmon.
I think I came on early on Captain Sabaton, and so I just kind of shrugged it off and smiled.
Oh-ho!
Backup dancers were like on it. Like I just said, I'll be up there in the middle and you guys stand there on the sides and do your thing. And they were like, whoa, they're doing their thing. It was like on. When I got down to the main level there and the kids were all sitting in the front, I think they were all just so mesmerized. They were just like, wow, what is happening here? Heave! Oh, heave! And so I just threw that in there at the end, just to fill in that space where all the magic was wrapping up into a big crescendo. Yay!
Den siste piraten som skal ombord på Den sorte dame for å kjempe om videre deltakelse I Alt for Norge Eric.
I'm ready to bring the audience what they came for. An explosive, entertaining, blah, 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 entertaining experience. We'll work on the words on that later. Let's find some gold today! All right, I'm going to sing you a song, but I want you to keep your eyes out for other sheeps that are trying to steal me gold!
I was surprised at how fully Eric immersed himself in his character. Eric, you know, the Viking was long gone. Eric stepped out as the pirate.
I am ready, and I expect to hear from my little pirates in the audience to help me along. We sail to the Caribbean, no anchor to be not. You're gonna hurt that camel, the omen held fantastic Scott! Captain Sabaton, Aaron Fowlingmon! No, yet looked it good, therefore ruin won't land. He's away, start a something more, so I'll be tired of hurting the soldier aboard. Would you like to come on my ship? I smell gold! Is there gold in the audience? Who wants to go on a pirate ship? I need a few first mates.
Eric definitely worked the crowd, and he got some kids up there, which it would be any kid's dream, so I'm sure he just bought two votes.
If you cannot dazzle them with details, baffle them with bullshit. And I brought bucket loads. What I like to call improvising. Let's spell the gold! Let's see those guns! Whiskey in the mouth! Boom, boom! Arr. I smell gold! Where are you going? Bring me treasure! Who's going aboard? Oh, yeah! Pirates! Eric the pirate! I
I will be staying in Norway to conquer the rest of the country and see the Hovland soon. Viking victory and pirate power.
Det er nå opp til de fremmøtte barna å avgjøre hvem av de tre som skal få være med videre I Alt for Norge. Den av deltakerne som får færrest stemmer må dessverre belage seg på at Norgesoppholdet slutt for denne gang.
Wow, all right.
I am actually not surprised.
This was a hell of a performance. You guys impressed us so much. Give yourself a big hand.
Yay.
I know this is a special moment, because soon one of you guys will have to walk the plank. And then, unfortunately, leave... Alt for Norge and Norway.
First, I would say you turned up this morning like landlubbers. this afternoon, you proved to be fully fledged pirates.
Oh,
that's
good.
Very impressive.
Good.
In my opinion, you're all winners.
Well, tusen takk.
Tusen takk.
Liv, your acrobatic flips was very impressive.
Thank you.
Awesome.
Eric, you look like a pirate, and your moustache is very good.
Props to the staff.
Yeah, but I think it was a very good idea to bring up some of the kids. And Greg, you also had some creative interaction with some of the crew. Mm-hmm. I think that was very good. But in the end, I'm not the one who decides who's going to win today. Somebody else has to decide, and that's the audience.
I have counted the votes. One of you totally raided the audience with 46% of the votes.
Whoa.
And that person is... Congratulations, you're safe.
You deserved it.
Whoa! You know, I had to hoop a little. I was safe and was super proud. Just really proud. Honestly, all I did was get out there and have the most fun I could possibly have and make sure the kids had the best time, too. And we connected.
Greg, can you describe what's going on in your head right now?
Yeah, my heart is going a million miles per hour right now, and it's, you know, I gave my all for Norway today, so it was, I'm very proud of my performance, and we'll see what happens.
I want to be here another week and take one step closer to meeting my family. That's still the core reason why I'm here right now.
And Liv, what about you?
I feel seasick. I was like on the edge of tears standing there at the end. Going home is going to be a huge blow for me. I'm not going to be able to meet my relatives. And that was the reason I came here. When I think back on it, like, I've worked so hard. I've gone through a lot of individual challenges. And every day, that's my motivation. I want to meet these people that I've started to learn more about.
Liv and Greg, two beautiful and brave pirates.
Oh, thank you.
One of you got 36% of the votes. And the other one got 18% of the votes. The person that soon will have to walk the plank and then, unfortunately, leave Norway and Alt for Norge is... Greg.
Congratulations, Lee. Wow. Wow. I want to say I was surprised because I'm a great performer and I thought I did a great job up there,
But at the same time, just Eric and Leave, they have those qualities that make kids smile and laugh. So hats off to them for going out there and putting on a great show for the kids. And they deserve to continue on.
We were both pirates.
Yeah.
Oh my God. It feels really good. I was trying not to feel so good. I mean, I felt really bad for Greg, but I was really sure it was going to be me that was leaving. And it was a huge relief.
As a fully-fledged pirate, it is my duty to see to that you can walk the plank.
Walk the plank. So this is it? Walk
this
the plank?
Is it.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Right back.
Awesome, I can walk the plank.
Honorable way
from should I do a triple double axel?
Yeah.
One of those? How about a big old cannonball?
Yeah.
That would be appropriate! Yeah.
That was a very fitting ending to walk off the plank on a pirate ship. After being a pirate for the day, that was no problem at all.
That's a pirate!
Greg!
Greg!
Greg, unfortunately, he had to leave us today. But he left like a proud, fighting pirate. He walked the plank with dignity. In fact, he did a very appropriate cannonball. And he went out with a bang. He really did. He gave his best performance, and I'm really proud of what he did today.
Og vil du se hvordan Greg reagerte på å måtte gå planken og forlate Norge, kan du klikke deg inn på tvnorge.no.
Leave, you're gonna put her down.
Oh,
pirates are here.
This is so cool.
So how are you two doing? How are you feeling? Congrats on a
fantastic.
Great performance. Yeah. You guys did so
well.
You were both so good.
This has really been one of the best days of my life. Mm. I have had such a fun time. I don't know what to expect.
My friends. Another great week, huh?
Absolutely. Yes.
Unbelievable. You've truly shown great interest in learning about the Norwegian childhood, I would say. I think you qualify as Norwegian children.
Oh, huge compliment.
My goal.
And now it's time for the little troll, our good old friend. And actually, this is the last time I will hand out the troll. So, the troll this week goes to a person that has shown a great enthusiasm all along this journey. This person has also shown a great interest in learning the Norwegian language. Så denne prisen går til Berit!
Congratulations! Tusen takk! Honestly, I am so honored to receive the Troll Spirit Award this week. I really just have been having such an amazing time on this trip, and a reward like this for like just having fun and having a great time is just unbelievable to me. I'm so excited about it.
Wow! Wow! Oh,
she's here.
Now we're getting out of the way.
The actual pterosaur.
Yes.
Okay, everyone.
Woo! It works, it works, it works. Don't
play. Oh my
gosh. Oh! Oh!
Neste uke skal amerikanerne få lære seg mer om det norske bygdelivet.
Rackfisk, kind of like if lutefisk and kulturmelk had a baby, and then I ate that baby's diaper.
Wow! Everybody should try that.
I'm done with this. I'm getting him.
Og de får vite hvordan livet arter seg i Trøndelag.
A-E-I-A-H-A-H-O.
Wild!
What are the bugs on the poop?
Oh, Eric.
Oh, but they're neat.